Hey, what's going on, you guys? Welcome to Pillow Talk with the Tea podcast. My name is Kwamea, but for those that can't pronounce my name, you call me Q Kwa or E the Queen. I'm your founder, CEO, creator, and most importantly, your host, the Pillow Talk with the Tea podcast. Tonight, we are here with another episode. And even if it's not nighttime, wherever your time zone, for all my listeners, viewers, and supporters, listen, we have another amazing episode, another amazing topic that we're going to sit, tip, and all around drink all across the board. So we do have an amazing king in the building that decided to come on so I could put his ass in a hot seat.
Nothing.
For what? So, of course, King, introduce yourself to the PTWTT family.
What's good, people? It's your boy Slept on the Dude. You know what I'm saying? Handling my thing, doing my thing. Loving TikTok is in the building. Oh, out here. You know what I'm saying? Thanks for the invite, Quinn. I truly appreciate that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And of course, you guys, I definitely came across him on TikTok, which TikTok is this big thing now. And I came into one of his amazing episodes of his show, Loving TikTok Pie, and I was like, oh, this is great. This is my tea right here. I like this. Yeah. So, of course, I had to send him an invite. So, tonight's topic is we talk about love and light of two plays. So, when I say that, do you think or do you believe that a person could love two people or be in love with two people at the same time?
I mean, to be completely honest, I believe it's possible. However, I believe that it's a very hard and very unstructured situation because, you know, the emotional effect, you know what I'm saying? You drain yourself trying to give all of yourself to two different people. Yeah, you'll drain yourself. You know, they say that, you know, you can only be in love. Most people believe you can only be in love with one person, but honestly, you can be in love with two people. But you can't be in two places at one time.
I mean, absolutely.
Honest feeling.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, I definitely believe that you could be in love with two people at the same time because I definitely was once in love with two people at the same time. I won't say it drained me, but that's basically, you definitely have to prioritize, for sure.
Those who can make it work, you're definitely going to be doing a whole lot of prioritization. You're definitely going to have to do some organizing.
Absolutely. It's a lot of, I won't say it's a lot, but you have to extend yourself for sure. And then I think basically me previously in that situation helped me sustain what I currently have now. So it's like easy breezy at Sunday morning. And then also me being more mature and experienced. And from me being 25 or 30 to me now being 41 is a huge difference of a gap of a lot more experience, life experience, relationship experience, and just basically just people experience. Because when you basically are end up falling in love with two people at the same time, you got to realize that it's two different personalities, two different aspects, two different opinions, two different everything. So, abso-freaking-lutely in regards to that. So, have you ever been in love with two people at the same time?
You know, to be honest, I try not to put myself in that situation because, again, for me, it's emotionally draining. Mm-hmm. There have been times where I've been in love with somebody and caught the attention of somebody else. And they can tell, you know. One person can tell when things are different. The other person can tell when the feelings are starting to grow. But they can also tell when I was keeping my distance for a reason. So, yeah, being in that situation, I had to come to a place where I had to make a choice. And I ended up missing out on a good thing because I made the wrong choice. So life happens, but you learn from your mistakes.
Absolutely. I think all of us do, but the ones that do, I feel like they end up connecting to the life universe and they get it at that point. And so what do you think about open relationships?
I believe that open relationships can definitely work out. Level of trust and understanding, communication, you know, and keeping a clear transparency. keeping a clear transparency amongst everybody, I think it could work out. I mean, throupleships work out quite a bit these days. You have a lot of polyamorous relationships that definitely work out. I mean, I can see the benefits on both sides of it. I'm open to it, but at the same time, I like to focus because I'm more of a family setting type of guy. You know, being raised in a two-parent household, you know, it's just, for me, I think those values are kind of stuck with me. So, like, I just prefer to be a one-woman man, I guess.
Okay, one-woman man. Yeah, so I definitely believe in open relationships because I feel like, you know, what maybe works for the goose may not work for the gander. And as I always, you know, say, each is all. You know, everybody's different. Whatever floats your boat may not also fit and floats my boat. So I always tell people that, like, I don't really judge no one situation. But I definitely believe with some people, open relationship does work when you put standards, boundaries, and you have structure. But when you just going out willy-dilly, then there's no structure, there's no boundaries, no type of anything to it, then it could be really messy. You know, like, even in regards to, I know somebody asked me recently, do you believe threesomes could work? I believe threesomes can work, but don't let that third person be a friend of either one of yours. That should be someone that you guys will never see again. It would be somebody that you are going to get acquainted with because you're looking to actually have a create and do a threesome, but you should also not be a person that you want to see in your everyday life, and damn sure not a friend. Why would you choose a friend from either your partner's side, either one of y'all sides, when knowing the fact that that could end up falling wrong on you? Because that person could have really had hidden agenda feelings for one of you. And finally, you implemented sex, it could open up a bag of emotions. And then somebody coming to somebody and say, hey, you know, I want to be with you. And, you know, I was having these feelings all this long time, and I think you should be not with him or with her. And so, like, this happened to a good friend of mine. And I was like, girl, the wrong thing you did was you did it with your best friend.
Actually, yeah, you definitely want to be in a neutral zone when it comes to that situation. You definitely don't want it to be a situation where you are, you know what I'm saying? It's either, I mean, in my case, you're my girl's best friend or a friend of my girl's or one of my female friends, because I don't want no ill will, no ill feelings, no hidden agendas, right? I think if you're going to do that type of thing, you definitely, as a couple, you definitely want to find somebody and get to know them together. And then slowly move into your, you know what I'm saying, what you're trying to accomplish in the situation, but you definitely don't want to involve somebody you know. You definitely want to find somebody new, so somebody that y'all can learn and kind of catch a vibe with together. Definitely.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I definitely agree with that. Now, what do you think about polyamory versus monogamy?
Well, I mean, to me, both of them work. I just feel like polyamory will have a much bigger benefit in a sense, depending on the boundaries that are set, depending on the communication between all parties involved. I mean, it's definitely a huge benefit. You know what I'm saying? There's many different benefits to it, but also, I guess, a monogamous relationship on the other side. I, again, coming from the household I come from, there's a lot of time investing, there's a lot of growing, but I feel like it also has this level of solidarity. Both can have that same effect, but again, when you're dealing with more than one person, y'all definitely all got to be on the same page. And I think, I mean, if y'all can get it to work in that area, great. You know what I'm saying? Because again, it's a benefit for all, especially if everybody's tuned in on the same page. I think on the other hand, a monogamous relationship is a lot easier to do because you're spending more time with that, you know what I'm saying, that one person. Y'all go through the ups and downs, and if y'all can tough it out, I mean, it's a beautiful thing either way.
Absolutely. I definitely agree. And that's why I say, like, because even when I do share with my situation, I tell people it's, you know, it's not like, you know, it's just kids over here playing. We are grown ass adults. Like, you got to think about who's the pieces on the chessboard. That's like, we ain't playing checkers, we playing chess. So, and I remember sharing even before, I say, listen, we are all three of us. We are entrepreneurs. We are grown ass adults. We all have kids. We, not only that, but we have businesses. We trustably know what's going on, what we're doing. So it's not like we high school or just young adults that say, like, you know what, we just want to be wild and free and little bucky bucky. But there's some people who do. But I have to always give out that dynamic and paint that picture, like, hey, it is structure, there's rules, there's full honesty, commitment. Not only that, but there's communication, which is the key of all love. Yep. Communication is a key language of everything, from familyship, friendship, love, everything. But also there's openness, no secrets. Everything is laid out on the table. And I tell people, in which I hear a lot of people like, it's not for me, which I tell them, no, it's not for everybody. It's damn sure ain't for everybody. And I know that it's not for everybody, because I've seen people who try to dive into it and it was like, nope, because there's people who feel like I'm stingy. I'm a jealous person, which is cool, you know, and it's not for me. And I say, with monogamy versus polygamy, I say, honestly, the difference between us is the fact that we have everything on the fucking table. We put everything on the table. And if there is to be anything to be shoved in underneath the table, we like, nope, bring it up. Or on top of the table. Like, we just, everything is out and open and transparent and communicative. And we are more free. To me, being in a monogamous relationship, I felt like there was times I wasn't as free as I am now.
Okay.
And I felt like there's so much room of freedom of me to keep, one, my individuality. I need my me time, you know? And the people respects that, because it's like everything that I require in myself become between individuality, which is my me time. Sometimes I do need my space and my time, but I also, in regards of just my peace, the love for myself and everything else around, just my energy, I protect my energy, protect my peace. But all of those that I have, it matches theirs, because they inquire and entitle the same thing. And I tell people, wait, you could be great and connect with the partner if their fly matches your fly.
Exactly.
The struggle comes when you're trying to make a piece, a puzzle, fit in the piece that it doesn't fit in. That's where the struggle at. And then you start thinking, I could change her. I could change him. Or the thing is, I hate it where the fact is, I had guys I dated before. And even one of my current partners, he said, even in one of his marriages, he was not able to freely be who he was. And it was like he had to alter himself to fit into whatever she required. And I say, that sounds like misery to me.
Right. You know what? I mean, you're definitely right. When you're in a monogamous relationship, it can be a struggle. You know what I'm saying? My thing is, I always try to create that atmosphere of openness, and I push individuality. I push freedom. You know what I'm saying? I want you to be who you are before I met you with me. You know what I'm saying? I want you to be that same person. If you're the type of person that like to go hang out with your girls on Friday night, y'all go kick it, y'all gonna go to the little male strip club. Hey, do your thing. You know what I'm saying? But me and my homeboys definitely gonna go hit the strip club, you know what I'm saying, and do our thing. Or, you know, if I go skating every Saturday night and you like to go bowling every Saturday night, do your thing. I'm not going to stop that. You know what I'm saying? I encourage individuality, because I feel like the more freedom you give a person, the more you allow them to be themselves, the more they want to connect with you, because you're not causing them to, or trying to force them to be somebody they're not. You know what I'm saying? People they get into a relationship and they feel like they have to change something about themselves. You don't necessarily have to pressure them with that. You know what I'm saying? They get into the relationship and they see, okay, well, he's got his thing going on. He's doing his thing. He seemed like he's the family oriented, you know, good old home structure type of person. I don't want to interfere in that, but I'm like, listen, I fell in love with the person you are. Not the person, you know what I'm saying? And I want to fall in love with the person you're going to grow to become.
Absolutely.
growing process together. But I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, cut your ties. I'm not gonna go, hey, go, you got male homeboys that you own for 30 years. I'm not gonna turn around and be like, look, you can't talk to dude no more. He got feelings towards you. I'm not that type of person.
Yeah.
I'm a jealous individual. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I push freedom. I put me time because I definitely need my time. I mean, listen, baby girl, it was good seeing you. I love spending my time with you. Man, I know you you've been here for, a couple of weeks, but daddy needs some time to just unwind, restructure myself, reset. I'll come spend some time with you. I'll come kick it with you. I mean, I'm not saying you're finna split up forever. That's not the thing.
Yeah.
I just a couple of days just to unwind and detox myself and free my mind up and definitely right back to it. That's not saying I'm gonna stop talking to you. I'm definitely gonna communicate because if I care about you, you're on my mind. You know what I'm saying? Definitely. It might just be, you hungry?
Mm-hmm.
Man, women love some food, right?
Honestly, we do.
Right. And I might even in that time, I might even write you a letter. You know what I'm saying?
Aww.
Because those type of things, they say absence make the heart grow fonder, and it really does. And people fail to realize how much taking that time apart from each other can really strengthen a relationship, whether it's a monogamous or even a polyamorous relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And it definitely causes that bond to grow. But again, trying to take a person out of their own lane, trying to force them to, fit into this cookie cutter type box. I'm not that blind. That's the thing I try to tell people, like, you're free to be who you are. All I ask is that you be very open with me because I'm going to be as open with you. I'm not going to change up who I am. But if our relationship causes me to grow into a new structure, if anything, is going to better me, because I want to be a better man as much as I can for that person. So
absolutely. Listen, I definitely applaud that, because I just feel like those who I call it over your neck, I can't do it. I've never been that type. I can't do it, but I don't know, I guess it's a struggle for people, because some people that really comfortable being by themselves or hearing the voices in their head, so they always need someone constantly around them.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, and I feel sad, but I just be hoping that those people at some point in time actually get to that point where they feel comfortable being by themselves and enjoying it. Like, shit, I love my alone time.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I want to tell my son, get the hell out the house, because I want the whole house to my...
No, I feel you. I definitely feel you on that. I mean, so, like, one of my favorite things to do, especially in, only in the summer up here in Minnesota, I like to get on my motorcycle and run. I'll get on my bike after a long day of work, I'll come home, make sure the kids are straight, make sure the house is straight, you know what I'm saying? And then I get on my bike, and it's like, sending the kids to the park for a couple hours. I'm gone.
Mm-hmm.
It's one way that I actually found it helps free my mind up. I think people should have those type of things, like, because sometimes, especially for those people who are married, you know what I'm saying? It's not a relationship issue. It's a marriage. Now, this is something a little bit different, you know what I'm saying? You definitely have a commitment that you have to adhere to, but it's, again, one of those situations where you have to learn how to be your own individual and not try to cause, you can't box a person in, mm-hmm. right? And I think a lot of people, especially those who get married, have this tendency to think that, don't get me wrong, those old family values that we grew up with definitely have some depth, but this is 2023 now. We're not doing the old school traditional thing. We're more modernized, but I try to bring those same values, but I don't box people in, you know what I'm saying? So definitely having a hobby, getting some type of free time. Look, I'm the dude, look, baby girl, get out the house, please get away.
Mm-hmm.
I was saying, because a lot of times you come in from work and you don't get that time to unwind.
Yeah.
Right? It's right to the kids, right to getting dinner done, getting the house cleaned up, getting prepared for a little bit of family time before school or work the next day. And it's rinse, wash, and repeat and keep going.
Yeah.
you have to find some way to, you know, free yourself. And then, like, I feel like people really do need to take the time to spend time alone and come back together and express, you know what I'm saying, how you feel, the things you thought about, and talk about things that you feel can make the marriage better or your relationship better. And even if it's just giving praise, baby girl, I missed you so much. I'm laying on my, you know what I'm saying? Let's watch it, whatever. Those things are important. You know what I'm saying? Those things are important. And so you have to find ways to structure that into your relationships and your marriages, because, you know, people get it, they get married and they feel like they got that whole bubble down.
No, I don't think even when Matthew and Neville had that, Paul, that, as you know, as you say, the whole ball game down, it, you got every play in the book to memorize, because you got to realize when, especially when it comes to marriage and even people that in long-term relation, like common law marriages, who don't really truly believe legally married, but they going to be with their partners for a lifetime. Right. I just feel like with you won't end up learning your partner, because your partner all over, because your partner is not going to be who your partner was from 2022 to 2023, because that person end up elevating, they transition into different things, they growing, they learning new things. So, and I feel like also this, and one thing I love about my partners is they pay attention. Mm-hmm. Now, when you pay attention to your partner, to the fact is where you know, oh my God, I could tell something wrong. I just hear the whole diaphragm in your voice, or I could just see it in your face, or just, you just don't sound right. Or I could just feel your energy, your aura. And it's so crazy and so funny, because like my partners be, I'm like, and then when you don't want to talk about it, I can't hide it. I cannot hide it for shit.
Like, and so I'm an empath and I pick up on everything, right? The more time you spend with the person, the more you get to know their rhythm. You understand? Mm-hmm. So, like, I'm that dude, I pick up on it. Like, you know what I'm saying? If I know you to be that perky individual, at the end of the day, you still got that little bit of energy. You just trying to make it work for the rest of the evening, and you're happy because you're off, you're free. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know, I kind of read that rhythm. And when that rhythm is off, I know it.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times men be asking, babe, okay? Yeah, okay. You know what I'm saying? And I'm that dude, like, look, man, if something wrong, talk to me. You know what I'm saying? Talk to me. Please open up to me. You know what I'm saying? I want to be your man. I want to be your counselor. I want to be your friend. I want to be your therapist. I want to be your side dude. I need to be everything you need me to be. You feel what I'm saying? So when you're off, I'm going to feel it. Yeah. You know, I might come in wearing a smile as much as you can, but I can read that eyebrow. I can tell your pulse. I can see it. I see all of that.
Yeah.
That's me, right? And then, this is me, I'm gonna keep asking, babe, you okay?
That's what I don't like, to keep asking. And I shared it with him, like, I say, let's do this. Steady, you keep asking, and I'm saying I'm not all right, because I already know you know that there's something wrong. I say the best thing for you to do is to say, hey, I know, honey, there's something wrong. You may not want to talk about it right now, but when you are ready, I am here.
Exactly.
And so when he does that, I'm like, okay, like, I come when I'm ready. But for some reason, like, soon as he freaking say it, I'm already spilling my guts.
Uh-huh. But see, that's that level, that thing you build with each other, right? You really have to build to that point, because you don't know what's on his mind. You don't know what's on her mind. And they may not know how to exactly express it to you.
Yeah.
It's something that's so deep and so hurtful that they're sad and they don't want to show their emotions at that point, or they might be angry, you know what I'm saying, pissed off, stressed out about something that took place, and they don't want to backfire and come off on you the wrong way. And I understand those things. My thing is, I'm like, look, I'll be like, queen, are you okay? Because I can see something's obviously right. And if you're not, you don't want to talk about it right now, that's perfectly fine. We can revisit it later. And here I go again. Let me pour you a glass of wine. Or let's go get something. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to do something to break the ice, because I feel like there's nothing my woman should not be able to come to me and talk to me about at all. I don't care what the hardest thing. I don't care how hard the situation may be. Hey, she might have kissed somebody. She might have did something, you know what I'm saying? that she knows is going to hurt me. Mm-hmm. But I respect her more for saying, look, you know what I'm saying? I can't talk about it right now. I don't know how to say this to you. I don't want to hurt you. Whatever it is, right? My thing is just don't leave me in suspense.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'm that dude. You can't, this is me. Don't hit me up. We need to talk when you get home.
Well, I don't like that. And I'm not even a woman that says that. I really don't.
Right. I mean, but I'm just saying that kind of situation where you leave a person in suspense.
You're thinking about it all day.
You throw their whole entire day off, and the whole time they're at work or they're doing whatever they're doing, they're out. Boom, 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 boom. We need to hurry up and cut this short. I need to go. Something's wrong, right? And it could be a good thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Be a good thing, but it's like, don't leave me in that suspense because, yeah. Man, babe, I got something for you, or babe, I did something I want you to see, you know what I'm saying? Hurry up so you can get home. That leaves me with, okay, babe, ain't nothing wrong.
Yeah.
First thing that goes, especially through a male's mind, even both ways, it don't matter.
Yeah.
Goes through a person's mind is something's wrong. I got to fix going on. You know what I'm saying? Like if I'm at work, especially, that's going to knock me all the way off my square. I can't best because my mind ain't in it. My heart ain't in it. I'm thinking about what's going on over here. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. I definitely agree with that 1,000%. And I'm just glad that I end up not being that type of woman because I don't like it with me. Because just like you say, someone say that to you, it throws your whole game off, your whole day is off track. And now you're thinking about, okay, something's wrong. Or what did you do? What did I say that I didn't know that I said? Like, it just be random thoughts. And it could be completely the opposite. And not even close to that. And like, it just be, so I definitely end up getting that. But also in regards to just with polyamory versus monogamy. And I always say this, that I know people in monogamous relationships, they probably hate me, but listen, fall in line. Get your ticket, but I don't know when you're going to get into the concert. So at the end of the day, I say in regards to that, I think to me, polyamory is a flyover more than monogamy. I just see it. Because that's why even so many people that's in monogamous relationships don't even know they're in poly. They just don't know the other partner.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And I get that. You know what I'm saying? Don't get me wrong. Like with my ex-wife, you know what I'm saying? She had a thing for women. You know what I'm saying? And there was nothing wrong with that. But what I noticed after being married to her for a year and after knowing her for so many years, I noticed there was a component or something missing, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's one of those situations where it was hard for her to come and talk to me about it. And I was like, you know, when she finally brought it out to me, I'm like, look, queen, well, if that's the case, come on, girl, we can go out, we go meet somebody, you know what I'm saying? Let's go meet them together. Let's get to know them, build it together. And I was all for it. I had no problem with that, but it's when you hide it, you know what I'm saying? It's y'all. And that's what I mean. You really got to take time to dive in and get to know a person. You know what I'm saying? You got to take time. Like, that's why I don't like secrets. I don't like, you know what I'm saying, hidden things. I don't like none of that. Put it all on the table with me, baby girl.
Yeah.
And you want, I'm that guy, especially when married. I want to be every man you need me to be. Even if that takes me stepping out of this way and allowing somebody else to come in to fulfill you in areas that I can't. And that's hard. And listen when I tell you, that's hard for men. That's really hard for men. You know what I'm saying? It's hard for some women, but some women are able to adapt a little bit better, but it's definitely hard for men.
Yeah. Yeah, I do believe that it's hard for a majority of some men, but there's very few men who are adaptable to it. You know what I'm saying? Because like even my second partner, he was like, I never done this before. I just need you to be patient with me, but because you are worth it, you are worthwhile, and I know I won't come across another woman like you, I am willing to do this, to try this, to be in this with you, than to lose you and not have you at all.
Exactly.
And by him, me basically gaining patience, he really helped me with patience because I even say, who am I to really rush someone that I know that I prayed for, that I asked for, that I know God sent to me? I dare not to be, you know, impatient by just being patient with him, because when you patient, listen, you get, patience is golden. You exactly. get so much reward for it. And trustably, I am getting a lot of awards and I'm happy with that. So absolutely. And there's times I still have to end up being, you know, patient with him in between periodically. But I'm okay with that because I know that me and him is on the same level. We're on the same plane. We walk in the same line and we're building to the same things. So absolutely. And it's like, I remember him saying to me, like, I am stingy. And I was like, you have no reason to be. Absolutely. No, you have no reason to be. And he knew exactly what I meant when I said that. So because I show him that rather than tell him, when you show somebody something than just constantly knocking their head with words, they feel it. They more, there's confirmation. There's no reservation. There's no doubts. There's no type of what is he doing with her over, I mean, what's she doing with him over there and vice versa. So it's like, because I put my money where my mouth is, there's no reservations. And just creating that environment and that space. And it's like, you could be able to create, I think a woman could create environment is what much a man needs and not just what he wants. If you create that own space and environment for yourself, it exactly. should not be that hard. But yeah, so listen, I love that you came on, but tell us about Love and TikTok Pod.
So Love and TikTok podcast, right? And livecast. Man, it was really just an open community discussion at first. I got on TikTok one day and I just wanted to talk to some people, you know, get some ideas of what I could do to make a difference in the community. I'm really focused on community and family and culture. And, you know, in our discussion, we was touching on a whole bunch of different things. I think that day we were touching more or less on men opening up and being vulnerable. And why it's so hard, you know? Yeah. And I mean, you know, they brought up the things that are, my bad.
Yeah, okay.
They brought up, you know, the normal things of, you know, men are made to feel weak when they show their emotions. Men are made to feel weak or not strong enough for certain women if they cry and things of that nature. I'm one of these people, I grew up knowing, hey, my dad was a very emotional person. He always expressed his emotions to me, to my family, my moms. You know what I'm saying? He was always emotional. And I'm sure that when you came, so you caught me in my emotions a couple times, you know what I'm saying, when certain situations come up, because I'm easily touched when it comes to beautiful things. Yeah. People out seeing other people reach their goals and their success, I get touched by that, right? Yeah. So one of the people that was in the room with me was like, hey, you know what? I love the way you make your space safe. I love the way that you talk to people and you encourage people. You know, you just got a lot of love to give.
Mm-hmm.
Name your show Love and TikTok. And I was like, you know, that's actually not a bad idea. And so, like I said, we touch on a lot of hard topics. We definitely sit at the table and discuss things within our culture, ways to better ourselves in our community, you know, holding men, brothers holding each other accountable.
Finally.
Yep. Learning how women and our kids, you know what I'm saying? Protecting things. Even when it comes to us having to protect ourselves from our own people, you know what I'm saying? It's not necessarily protecting ourselves, but teaching each other, look, bro, we've been fighting long enough. We've been fighting long enough with everybody in the world coming at us, why we gonna fight each other and tear each other? You know what I'm saying? I do things like love sessions, loving on you sessions, where I'll have people who've gone through certain things or dealing with certain health issues or whatever, come on the show and tell their story. And immediately my team and everybody in my audience get immediately after they tell their story, they words of encouragement, just trying to love on them. And so, like, my following was real small when we started that, but quickly gaining momentum. We've had so many people come in and they're like, man, I truly love your space. I can be an adult here. I don't have to worry about people judging me. You're inviting and warm and welcoming. Like, and we've had a lot of tear jerker nights, you know, putting people in the hot seat, giving people an opportunity to talk, tell them their story, you know what I'm saying? Put a little pressure to them, see if we're going to get the truth out of them. And I mean, and people come open and transparent, and I love that. Ever since we started doing it, man, it's just been a ball rolling. It's just constant movement. The following is growing slowly but surely. We definitely have a solid backing. We've had a couple incidents that's taken place, but for the most part, it's just been, man, it's just been fun. I mean,
yeah.
I see. Caught you slipping, right? We got you up in there, you know, and in truth and reality, like I said, there's not too many people that can cause me to get speechless, but you, girl, my whole team was like, baby girl got swag. We need her. You know, but yeah, you know what I'm saying? We just allow people to be themselves, man. We welcome people, and we just try to empower people, try to love on people, and try to push people to their success. And definitely let people know that they have a support system, man. If you ain't got nobody else in the world, you can definitely hop on Love and TikTok, and we right here every night.
And I love that. I really do, because I feel like there's so many people who actually need that, and they don't even know where to begin or to start. I get so many people in my messages, in my DMs or emailing me and say, hey, I want you to be my mentor. I want you to just be, you know, my confidence booster. And that's why something part of me decided to say I am my sister's and brother's keeper, as well as I like to ignite confidence in building motivation, inspiring, encouraging others. That's something that I was doing that I didn't even know I was doing since I was a young person. And people used to always say, like, hey, you're doing something, and I don't know if you even know that you're doing it. But I'm just glad that there is a space on social media that you have created for people to feel safe, not feel judged, to be able to be transparent and to be open and actually tell their stories and feel like they could find, you know, a safe space, because people out here don't have, you know, we may have, like, for instance, you have your kids or whoever your partners. I have my partners and my children and my family. We got to realize that everybody don't have that.
Right.
So I tell people, like, be careful. And I also, this is my thing, because I won't say crucified. I had to go head to head with two or three guys on Instagram 2 or 3 years ago and on live. Because me, I'm the type of person, you want to talk about it, let's talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
I talk to you behind the scenes, but I feel like now something needs to be said out loud in front of the scene. So, and I went head to head. Me, I take on any man, woman, child, baby, cat, dog, or fish.
Right.
And so with that, I was just letting them know, because they felt like it was the men saying, oh, so now we have to feel like we got to be responsible and reliable for people's feelings to whatever may be said in the comments to them. I say, absolutely. I say, then that lets me know that you just doing the shit just to do the shit for entertainment. And that basically, to me, I'm looking at your platform or your live as if you're welcoming me to your house. So right. Basically, if I come in your house, that lets me know I'm not safe. So that's like, basically, you have somebody on your platform, you are to sit there and treat them with the utmost respect and hospitality and making sure they say. So if something in the comments, something being said, that's supposed to be checked and removed. Now, if you allow stuff like that to go on, then I got to question you.
Exactly. Exactly.
And listen, I had people in the comments like that and try to go with them. But then when I start making sense, now all of a sudden Q, you right, Q. Because you got to think about it. Yes, this social media is an escape for so many people, because a lot of people don't have other people so they could call on, lean on, or to get be entertained by. And again, social media could be just a bullshit to people, could be entertainment, just the fly, being a troller, just being an asshole or a keyboard bully. But also social media here also is for people to sit there and to expand their businesses. But also to have people to feel safe, to release, to be encouraged, to be motivated and inspired, but also have a safe space for them.
Exactly. And that's exactly what I want to do. I look at it as like making waves in the ocean. You know what I'm saying? There's so many different influences that goes into social media. There's so many different opinions that goes into it. You would not believe the amount of changes people make just because of something they seen on social media, something they heard on social media. You know what I'm saying? Those type of things affect people. Mm-hmm. And what I wanted to do was normalize loving on social media. I want to normalize empowering on social media. And there's a lot of great content creators out there that's doing that, but not all of them are all doing it in the way that I'm trying to do it, because I want people to be able to come and express themselves. I'm not here to entertain you. I'm here to uplift you. That's all I'm for. And like I said, I'm trying to bridge these gaps, you know what I'm saying, in our relationships. There's so many different things that need to be worked on at home. We have so many absentee fathers at home. You have so many absent moms going through a whole bunch of stuff. You got single fathers playing both roles, single mothers playing both roles. Those people need help. They need resources. And me personally, I want to help bring back that whole village effect.
Yes.
I want to bring that whole village effect. And I feel like I'm starting to do that with Love and TikTok. Because I mean, you've seen how it was.
And listen, as I tell people also, you guys have to realize that, you know, people are human. When you come on, you don't know what people are dealing with, and you got to be very cautious of things that you say. And I also tell this to so many people, is that each room is space for, you know, any social media. It's like if you're watching TV, you don't like the movie, you don't like the show, turn the channel, go to the next room.
Definitely. Definitely. But like I said, I'm trying to bring that village back. We have to have that village effect, right? Because when we grew up, the street light came on, we knew what time it was.
Yeah.
Right? When we grew up, we did something wrong at school, we got off the bus, our neighbors already knew what was going on, and mom and dad wasn't home. You get over here, you go sit right here.
Mm-hmm. Right? You know work. Yeah.
Know what I'm saying? You had the friend auntie, you had your real aunties, you know what I'm saying? But I'm trying to bring that effect back around, because this next generation, they need it. Mm-hmm. They need it. I feel like we felt already, and we just need to start picking the pieces up, because as a culture, as a whole, as a community, we're in a place right now where we truly do need each other. You know what I'm saying? We're fighting against so many different powers out here, and we just need to restructure our community. And stop worrying about what we've already been through. We got babies coming into this world. We need village fathers. Mm-hmm. Brothers need to step back up. You know what I'm saying? Protecting those single moms. Mothers need to step back in. You know?
Mm-hmm. True.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, I mean, because there's men out here, man, like there's men out here raising girls on their own and don't know what they're doing.
Yeah. Yeah, I have an uncle who raised twins, a boy and a girl. He was a single father. And trust and believe, like by me saying that shows me that there's no gender on parenting. And it could be hard and difficult either way. You know what I'm saying? Because this has not come with the manual. And like you leave out the hospital and the nurses say, you know what, here's your manual for parenting. Good luck.
Right.
No, you gotta figure the shit out.
I mean, and truthfully, we're the last of those babies that actually understood that, you know what I'm saying? Who had that grounding under us, you know? And even though we hold these values, we've also gone through life and it's caused some changes, you know what I'm saying, in certain areas. And we didn't always have the answer. We didn't always have resources. We didn't always have the necessary help, you know what I'm saying? So we have to figure it out. Nobody's perfect at it. No book written on it that's perfect, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, we got to do better.
You know, we do.
I feel like Love and TikTok is that grounds for educating parents, single parents, parents that are together. I feel like it's that ground for making new connections, rebuilding that village. I feel it's that ground for healing, definitely.
I was just about to say that. I was like, I also see that it's definitely grounds for healing, because just my observation of me seeing it and just seeing certain people that comes on the panel to speak, I'm like, I could just see, and just like how you say you're an empath, I'm true. It's like, oh my God, I feel like when my grandmother, God rest her soul, I feel like when she passed, she like, a lot of things she passed over to me. That's why my son sometimes may not understand when I say, you know, back up, get away from me, certain things. And then like, and I feel like I took a lot of things in my grandfather, the thick skin, the transparency, unapologetically don't give a fuck attitude. So just them two is a beast.
Right.
Well, me taking on those things, and it's like even when I end up was observing and watching, I was like, yeah, there's a lot of healing going on, and there's some continued healing that needs to be going, that needs to continue to go on. But I'm just glad that he has a space for the individuals to be able to do that, because I know about the healing journey, and I went through my emotions and my roller coasters of my healing journey, and I'm still in my journey. Mm-hmm. You know, just I'm further along than many other people, but it's not a 9-to-5. It's not a Monday to Friday. It's a lifestyle. Yep. It's a 365. And I tell people, you also have to be patient with yourself. You have to trust the process. But also, I don't like when people be in the now. I don't like the in the nows.
Right. That whole the denial situation. And a lot of times, we have to pull people out of that. You know what I'm saying? Growing up, my dad used to tell me the enemy of success is comfort.
Mm-hmm.
People have to come up out of that comfort zone. You know what I'm saying? In order to really face what you're dealing with, because people will stay in that comfort zone just so they don't get hurt.
Yeah.
In that comfort zone so they don't feel like their world is being rocked. But sometimes you got to shake it up. You know what I'm saying? Don't. That what used to just be dust on your shoulder turns into hard cement. You know what I'm saying? And now you stuck, you know? So you definitely got to shake it up. You definitely got to come up out of it. And denial is the biggest freeze of all things. Like, as long as you're going to continue denying, you're going to keep running into that same brick wall, and you're still trying to insanity.
Mm-hmm.
You can't keep doing the same thing and expect to get different results.
Yeah. And basically doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results, it is called insanity. Exactly. But people continue to do it. And in regards to that, I just be wanting my brothers and sisters to understand the fact is that sometimes we just need to be quiet, and sometimes we just need to take it in. And especially if there's a safe space that you know was, you felt safe to come on.
Mm-hmm.
So feel safe to just listen and take it in, and not to listen to respond. And there's also a lot of sisters that I do see, they constantly saying what they are. But I could tell by the energy, I could tell by the attitude, I could tell by the body language, I could tell by so many things that a sister could sit there and say, hey, I'm this, and I could tell you're not.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't feel it. I don't even see it. Your mannerism is not showing me. And then why you have to keep pounding me with the same word is telling me you're not. Because a person could see when someone done the work. The person could see, damn, you doing the work, you're healing. I could tell you, you're healing process, aren't you? You know what I'm saying? Keep going, keep scribing. You know, keep jumping over those hurdles. But when I see many sisters that constantly like, oh, I'm doing this, and this is what I'm doing. I did this, and I did the work. Da-da-da-da-da. When you doing that to me, that shows me you haven't even begun.
Man, so I have this thing where I tell people their character precedes them. When a king or a queen enters the room, their presence precedes them. You know the king and the queen is coming. You see what I'm saying? So you don't have to say anything. They don't have to say, I'm the king. They don't have to say, I'm the queen. They know when you get there. Your stride gonna tell it. You know what I'm saying? Your look gonna tell it. Your vibe's gonna tell it, right? So don't tell me you up in here, you're doing this and that and the other. Listen, I'm not even worried about what you're doing. Are you real with yourself?
That's the part. Because you could get off of here, but you're still gonna be in the pain. You're still gonna be in the misery. You're still gonna be in that part, in that space where you are feeling fucked up. You know, so to start peeling back those layers and those not to feel fucked up and start healing and to get up off, literally, you may not be literally on the ground, but literally you on the ground, you know. So in regards to start building yourself up to be able to actually, like they said, Michael Jackson said, to look at the woman and the man in the mirror and to be comfortable and vulnerable to do so.
Mm-hmm.
Then that's when we say that you are in that process. You are in that process, or you are in the journey, and you see it. You see it. Because I remember my therapist, she was like, I want you to script being naked one day in the mirror. And I want you to look at yourself with your flaws and all, and I want you to accept it. Even if you can't accept it that moment, I need you to do it every day until you can.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, but even if you gotta cry, you better cry.
Let it out.
And so she said, cause every day that part will allow you to be able to not only love your internal self, but your external self.
Right.
And so, but you are definitely right in regards to a king and queen does not have to tell themselves in the building. And I tell many people, because when people, I tell people, first of all, I never gave myself the name queen. Mm-hmm. I tell people that, like, listen, it was given to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I represent it, you know what I'm saying? And I had many people who also told me, they say, when you step in the building, people notice you in the building. And I never knew what this lady was talking about. She was like, you have a presence and this light is over you. She said, when you speak with authority and people listen.
Mm-hmm. Right. I mean, and I get that a lot myself. Like, I mean, I'm sure you heard it a few times in my mm-hmm. life. People was like, man, bro, you doing things out here. You know, I don't really, I don't try to per se to, pretend to be somebody's counselor or therapist or anything.
Oh, no, please don't. I tell people, please, I'm not your therapist. I'm not your counselor. I go to school for it. All of the information I'm giving you is called life experience.
Exactly. And I mean, sometimes it's just making sure that the right person hears the right thing. And sometimes people need that life spoken in for them. And that's where I come from. I come from a place of light. I mean, my dad, my superhero, that's all he ever put in us. You know what I'm saying? Every day, every morning, you know what I'm saying? I had to greet my sisters. You know what I'm saying? Good morning, beautiful. Good morning, queen. I had to literally every day, you know what I'm saying? But it was speaking life into him, and I did not know that. You know what I'm saying? There was times my sisters or my friends, my female friends, my cousins were going through things, and just that greeting alone was enough to lighten their load for the day. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what it is. I just internally, I felt like I had all this extra love, all this extra hope, all this motivation and inspiration that I needed to get out, because it's overflowing with me and I don't know where to put the energy.
Yeah.
TikTok was my outlet for that.
Listen, I get it. I get it, because my podcast is definitely my outlet for it, because I wasn't the one even that was deciding about a podcast. I was not thinking about a podcast. The podcast was damn sure not on my mind.
Right.
It was actually, it was lit. The flame was lit in my belly through a family member who basically say that, you know, I think you need to start a podcast. And I say, why would you say that to me? Like, I'm offended right now. Like, be like, no. I'm saying you need to start one because she say, first of all, you take on being a mentor, an oldest, because you are, I'm the oldest. I'm the first grandchild and I'm the first daughter. So I'm the first cousin to the whole tribe in my age range and underneath. So she was like, the thing is, she said first her, and then she gonna put we. I said, who is we? Because they not saying nothing.
Right.
So she was like, no, we just saying that because I feel like we was blessed to have you in our life.
Mm-hmm.
It was the internal portal, basically, for us to have you, because you was here before us. So in regards to that, you was created for us because we came after you. So right. you tell it like it is. You don't sugarcoat. You let us know what we want, what we need to hear, and not what we want to hear. You don't care if it hurt us, because you're giving it with us like a punch of love to the gut. And she said, I feel like many women, even men or young men, meet a person like you in their life that who isn't blessed. And if they are blessed, they may not receive that person every day in that type of way.
Exactly.
So, and she was like, listen, you don't sweep it under the rug. You don't sugarcoat it. And you talk about that big ass pink elephant in the room, because me, I'm keeping everybody accountable. I even hold my mother accountable. And when she fucked up, I say, Ma, you fucking wrong. And she don't like that, because some people don't like when you hold the mirror up to them.
Boy.
It's so uncomfortable. And I can tell when she get uncomfortable. Because so many people tell that me and her, they be like, yeah, y'all are just two peas in a pod. But I tell people, this is what people used to say a long time ago. So now I say, listen, I don't know what you're going to call us now. I say, I do still have some of my mama traits. But then get some of the shit that I know, like, I make those changes, because my mother could be something else, I swear. And I don't want that. And so, but yeah, I hold up the mirror to my family members. I hold them accountable. I put their motherfucking hand to the plane.
Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes that's just the pressure they need. That's exactly the pressure they need. I mean, I know myself, again, accountability was a big thing. And my parents, me being a PK.
Oh, God.
Right? my parents wasn't going. They weren't going. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, even over time, you know, I had to address certain issues in my own life. I was very angry, didn't know I was angry, and it wasn't until somebody pointed it out in a way that I understood that allowed me to address holding that mirror up in front of me, right? And once I addressed it, man, it was a release. It was like a big weight off my shoulder. I felt free. I smiled a whole lot more. You know what I'm saying? People didn't see me as the dude with the resting bitch face.
Yeah.
And like, because like, I mean, there's so much in me that I want to give, but I was angry about a lot of things. But once I was able to address that anger and start realizing the things that would trigger me, that anger's fading. You know what I'm saying? And that came behind it was everything that I really wanted to be in life. You know what I mean? And that's where I'm at now. So it's like, my bad. It's easier for me to give that energy to other people and put that mirror up. Man, I'm telling you, when they see that mirror, they're like, you didn't have to do that.
Yeah.
But I did do it, because if I didn't put no light to it, if I didn't show you who you were for real, you can't change it.
Nope.
Oh, when you're holding on to things, holding on to grudges, holding on to past situations, you can't move forward. Those are those chains that's holding you back. Mm-hmm. And to do is be the best that you can. That's all. But it starts with you viewing yourself. You know what I'm saying? Dealing with yourself. If you don't deal with you first, you can't move forward. Period.
Now, what do you say? Because this is something I always say to, I don't believe in this, but this is an old saying for our grandparents and beyond. She just set in her ways, you know, so she's not going to, you know, change because, you know, she just set in her way. Because that's something my parents used to this day.
Right.
And I'd be like, when I hear that, it just make me just cringe. And I'm like, you ain't dead. So you still here to learn new things. I said, you no longer have breath in your body. You could continue to elevate, continue to tap in to be the best version of yourself and to learn new things. So why are we about to sit there and have the slavery mentality talking about I'm just setting my ways?
You know what? I'm sorry. I could never get stuck in my ways. You were right about that. As long as I have the ability to learn, I have the ability to grow.
I'll make sure I play this back for my mother. Like, see, listen, it's not just me. Can you listen to this king right here?
Right. Right. No, I'm dead serious. Like, and like, for instance, let me just put it to you like this. I watched my daughter. My daughter, she's 2 years old, right? She fought hard to get here.
Mm-hmm.
But now that she's here, I am so amazed every time I see her growing, every time I see something new about her, right? And then I think about her, okay, she's two now, but when she's 22 years old and the life and all that pressure, she's going to be like, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. I'm like, baby girl, calm down, center yourself, realize what you're dealing with. Categorize it and deal with it one task at a time.
Yeah.
Once you knock those problems out, you've learned something. What you have learned is you're going to go through things in life. There's this wave you're dealing with, and what you have to learn how to do is stay in the center. So no matter how life goes up and down, you're always balanced.
Come on now. You better teach them. You better teach those princesses that's going to grow up to be queens. Period. So where can the people be able to come and find the Love and TikTok podcast, which basically already gave it away, TikTok, but what days and times do you basically go on?
On TikTok, we do Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and Saturdays. Normally it's 6 p.m. or 6:30 p.m. Central Standard Time to 9:30 p.m. for our regular hard topic conversations. And then we get off into our hot seat a little bit, and then, you know, and then there's times we've been on there until 3:30 in the morning with the after dark sessions.
Oh yeah, I've seen that. I say they are still up, and I come in a room, I say, listen, I'm going to bed on them because it is not happening.
Right. I mean, but the thing is, and I'm going to explain something real quick. I'm not going to hold you, but I will definitely want to explain something. There are people, right, during the day, their bosses, their workers, their moms, their dads. And then at the end of the day, when they put their kids to sleep and they shut their house down, you never know who's in their room just crying.
That's true.
you never know who's in a ball of depression or anxiety. You know what I'm saying? And every time without failure, and that's the reason why I continue to stay up tired and sleepy, because every time without failure, we'll be in the middle of a after dark session and somebody will come in the room and, you know, they want to get in the hot seat and have fun and be an adult. And then something triggers them in an emotion, right? And immediately, I don't know if you got the chance to catch this yet, I will immediately stop everything I'm doing because I'm finna address that problem. I'm finna address that issue. I'm finna address that depression. I'm finna do whatever I can to lift your spirits up and let baby boy, whatever it is, you got a problem you need to deal with. We're here.
Mm-hmm.
Here. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got nobody else to talk to. You can go and watch Love and Hip Hop on TV. You know what I'm saying? You can go watch Real Housewives of LA on TV. And mm-hmm. you know, it takes your mind off of what you're dealing with. But how about we turn that around and we address it? This is not entertainment. Let's deal with real life right here and right now. We can get back to the after dark. We'll ask you all those questions. You know what I'm saying? Put that smile on your face. But right now, I want to know what's hurting.
Yeah.
And
I like that. I really like that. Like taking care of the problem right there and then. And I really like that. Putting a spotlight on it to not acting like we just going to breeze over, like we don't feel it or we don't see it. Right. And then I always tell people, you can watch TV all you want, but you got to be careful what you are internally allowing in, because those certain things could be in your psyche and could turn that depression into even more ill depression, because you got to be conscious and intentional what you choose to watch. Okay. Because, and then the thing is, I had stopped watching reality TV for a while because I wasn't really in that right mental mind to accept it. Because I remember one time I was in a relationship and because they was arguing on TV, I took the energy on and me and him having an argument. And I was like, and he said to me, he's like, hold on, why are you arguing with me? Because you're watching that shit on TV. Right. So he's like, we were just cool. So, and when he pointed that out, I had to check myself and look in too. But listen, I love my Love and Hip Hop, and I love my Housewives, different, you know, cast from different cities. But I'm not taking on what they taking on. What I now, how I look at it when I watch it, I'm like, this bitch knows she need therapy, or this bitch knows she wrong. She knows she's gonna be
right.
That's how I take it on and I look. So where can the people could find you on social media, any YouTube channels, and when is your podcast is coming back, or is it already out?
Actually, we were supposed to be starting our recording this week for our podcast to launch next week on Spotify.
Okay.
But like I explained to you right before everything, you know, before we started, you know, the devil's always trying to get in your way and steal from you. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you know you have a powerful message and you're doing something right. Because if that's not taking place, there's something wrong for real. Like, and so, you know, even though somebody came and hit me for my equipment, I'm going to keep doing my live cast. We'll be on tonight. Actually, tonight, Miss Liza is going to take control and hold the reins tonight.
Y'all doing it.
Yeah. She's going to be busting it at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time, 9 p.m. Eastern. Miss Liza is actually going to take control. I really wanted to give my team the opportunity to get out there and shine, man. Mm-hmm. Because they do so much to support me. I mean, they be in the comments sniping. You know what I'm saying? Don't get caught. They be in the comments sniping all the trolls and everybody because we maintain a safe space for real.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
But normally it's Monday, Wednesday, and Friday and Saturday night, 6:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. For our hard topics. And then you go into the grown and sexy thing after that. And we just up having fun, sipping, talking, and enjoying each other, making connections. You can definitely find me on YouTube. Love and TikTok Podcast is on YouTube. We're also on Instagram. Same thing, Love and TikTok Pod. And on Twitter. So if y'all ever want to reach out, hit your boy up, but you can definitely find me on TikTok every day, all day. That's just where I'm at.
Exactly. Definitely go find him.
Right.
I definitely appreciate you for coming on, accepting my invitation. And what words of encouragement and parting tea would you give to the people in regards to just generally throughout the topics and conversation we have that they could walk away with?
Listen, live every day, not in fear. Walk with your head high.
Come on.
Know that you're going to make it. As long as you can breathe, you can keep moving. You see what I'm saying? As long as you breathe, you can keep growing. Let nothing hold you back. Fear nothing. No man, nothing on this earth can stop you.
Yeah.
Especially brothers, take some time to go express to any woman. This is what I ask all the time. Brothers, take some time to go uplift a sister no matter what. Just tell her how beautiful she is today. You know what I'm saying? Sisters, do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
How handsome they are. How proud.
Yeah.
Tell a brother how proud you are.
Ooh.
You don't know the change. You don't know the change you can put in people's life that way. Here, I'm getting
I definitely agree. And my fraternity to you guys, as I always, you know, say, be unapologetically you. Be transparent. Do not allow people to dictate your life. You are your own valuable MVP. Not only that, but also smile. Smile, ladies. The bitch resting face is tired. You know, it's time to smile. You never know. As you know, my brother just said, you basically just telling someone how proud they are or telling someone how beautiful they are. You don't know what that person may go through. So just a smile from just a beautiful sister could end up changing that feeling and emotions of another kid. Just saying, oh my God, that your smile is so radiant. And just spark up a conversation. And just because we smile at one another or we give each other compliments, don't mean we want to fall in the bed with them. That's just a general humane thing to do as people. And we have lost that touch, and we need to regain and build that bridge, as he said, to get back to connecting. Because as my father used to always say, together we stand, divided we fall. And at some point, we got to come back connected in some way, shape, or form. And as I always say, don't be the shade to no one's light, be the light to someone's shade. Exactly. So I appreciate you so much. You guys, make sure you go check out the podcast. Make sure you go follow him. Subscribe to him, like, comment, and share again to all his social media platforms, and continue to support the brother, because support is free. And not only that, but who is going to support us if we don't support us?
Right?
Just saying. But thank you so much. I appreciate it. You know, I will be in that building later on. I'll be like, beep, beep.
Come on. You know? And no, thank you, Queen. Thank you so much. Like, I truly appreciate you, you know what I'm saying? Allowing me to come in and shine a little light of your platform, man. You had me skeptical for a second.
Oh, God.
You know what I'm saying? You hit me with the surprise topic, but no, I truly enjoyed myself, Queen. Thank you.
You're so welcome. Okay. Thank you so much, PTWTT family. I appreciate you tuning into another episode. Make sure you go follow, like, subscribe, and comment, and go follow us on all social media platforms. And as I say, if you are already a part of the PTWTT family, don't be stingy. Share it with people who aren't. You know, people may need to hear these words of encouragement, as well as be uplifted, inspired, encouraged, and motivated as well by all the amazing guests that I'm having on this season. And also, don't forget that we on every podcast platform, don't matter what it is. And I say, you can't pick one, Google it, and you just play any, mini, miny, mo. But so I do appreciate you guys so much for tuning into another episode of Pillow Talk with the Tea.